Now, we will shift to accounting of GST, which is now becomes relevant for you. Input GST, as we discussed earlier, is GST paid on intrastate sale, that is within the state, of goods and services. Besides this, a deposit also may be made in GST. So the total of this amount becomes input CGST. That means CGST paid on intrastate purchase less goods returned, destroyed, given as free samples, given as charity, or taken as drawings is input GST plus what CGST has been deposited. This total comes to input CGST. Similarly, SGST, input SGST is the GST paid on intrastate purchase of goods and services besides the deposit of SGST. The total comes to input SGST. Similarly, IGST, it is the GST paid on interstate, that is outside the state, purchase of goods and or services. Besides, some amount may be deposited into IGST account. This total becomes input IGST. So, what is input input GST? In the case of intrastate sale, intrastate transaction, it is the CGST paid on purchases less goods returned or destroyed or given as free sample or given as charity or taken as drawings plus the GST deposited. It becomes input GST. As we have just discussed, separate account for input CGST, separate account for input SGST, and separate account for input IGST are maintained. Similarly, we will maintain separate accounts for output CGST, output SGST or UTGST, and output IGST. Output CGST is the tax, is the GST collected on intrastate, that is within the state, supply made, that is sale of goods and or services. Similarly, it is SGST collected on intrastate supply made of goods and services. And when interstate supply or sale of goods and services is made, it is categorized as output IGST. Why this is necessary? It is necessary because input GST is set off against output GST, that is collected GST, in a prescribed order, that is as prescribed in the Act. And the order is, or the method of setting off of input GST against output GST is, first let us take output collected IGST. It is to be set off first against CGST, first against IGST, then if the balance remains, against CGST, and if still the balance remains, against SGST or UTGST. But remember, it has to be set off in this prescribed order. That is first IGST, then CGST, and lastly SGST or UTGST. If there is still a balance left, credit balance left, it is to be paid, and if there is a debit balance, that is to be carried forward to next month to be set off in the same order. Then second is output collected CGST. First, it is to be adjusted against CGST and then against IGST in this order. That means output CGST and cannot be set off against SGST. It can only be set off against CGST and IGST. And third is output SGST and UTGST. This can be set off first against SGST or UTGST and then against IGST. So this makes it very clear that CGST cannot be set off against SGST and SGST cannot be set off against CGST. So this is important. Now before you is the tax invoice. Now the seller is located in Delhi, purchaser is located in Haryana. So in this case, the seller has levied IGST. And this second specimen is of intrastate. Here the seller is also located in Delhi and purchaser is also located in Delhi. So that means it is an intrastate sale or intrastate supply. In this case, state GST and CGST it will be levied. Since it is located in Delhi, state is represented by DGST, Delhi GST. With this, let us now see the journal entries that will be passed. But I must share with you with the introduction of GST and all the goods and or services, virtually all now being covered under GST. Lot of chapters in your class 11 and maybe in class 12 also will change to give effect to the GST provisions.